the deal, y'all? It's the Thenterview podcast, and I'm here at 1417 The Spot, and we about to give y'all a live tour and a live interview with the owner.
Man, what's the deal? So, what we're working on here is a creative space for just all artists of all mediums in Detroit.
What we found was an abandoned broadcast network. It's been abandoned since the 70s, and so what we did when we got in here was immediately start demoing the work. We started about January taking everything out of the space. All of the walls were completely covered in wallpaper. It was wood on the walls, and there was carpet throughout the entire space. Everywhere you walked, it was carpet. So that's what the first thing that we worked on was trying to get this space up to par with demo. The first one we worked on when we got in the spot was actually this one.
This is the craziest.
Yeah, this one's right here.
We wanted to start drawing some income. We got in here. So what we did, took the carpet out, painted the walls black, put the lights in. Then we built the wall right here, built a side wall. And we got to work. So this is where we started working at first.
So how long did this process take?
It took us about a month total when we got in this room. We got the lease in like November, started demoing in January, and then we actually started building this in January. But we were done about February.
So how did y'all know whose idea was it to put the psych wall in this room specifically?
When we got in here, when we toured the space in like July, it was just a big open room, so of course the wall wasn't there, and it was big enough. So I had the vision already, knowing that I wanted to build a one-stop shop where if an artist came in and they created their song and they recorded here, they would be able to actually shoot the video the same day, you know what I mean? Or at the same place, they just know that they have a full creative workshop. So I knew what I wanted, and I knew what I wanted to look for, what I was searching for while I was looking for studio space. And when we saw this big room, it was like the perfect location.
So talk about some of the rappers that been in here so far.
Man, we
used this space.
We've had some good traction so far. I think the first big name rapper that we had used the space was Icewear Bezo and Lil Yachty. Yeah, Icewear Bezo and Lil Yachty shot in here. We had Kodak Black, we had Mac and Cheese, we had Gillo come to the spot. All of the major Detroit rappers, Peezy, Sterl Gotti, Los and Nutty, Babyface Ray, Wood Boy G from Florida.
How are y'all getting all these connections though?
Man, really, we was tapped in with all of the cameramen throughout the city, and that was like the connect that we had. We had already known all the cameramen because I'm an artist manager myself, and so we had worked with a lot of artists. We had worked with a lot of cameramen shooting videos for my own artists, and then just word of mouth, you know, and it spread fast. We had some really good traction early on.
All right, now we're about to show y'all the studio where your favorite rapper was just recording. You feel me?
We had some big names come to the studio to actually record too.
So this is Studio A. This is the first studio that we worked on. We have three studios in total. This is Studio A. This is the first one we worked on. We got done in about March with this one, because as soon as we got done in that project, we moved here. So this is the second phase that we wanted to work on.
How are all these walls looking like?
So when we came in here, the infrastructure for the actual studio was already here. This is a broadcast network before, so they had that room where they would actually shoot, and they would broadcast news networks and westerns out of here. And so that room was already built like that, with the glass was there, and then every room was already sound insulated prior to us coming here. What we had to do was just all cosmetic updates. Like I said, there was carpet throughout, and here we had to put the floor down. We had to paint the rooms, paint the shelves, and drop the equipment. Other than that, everything was already ready to go, sound insulated for us, so it was a perfect location. So that actually does double as a vocal booth as well. So even though it's in a live sound room, even though that's the white wall room, a live band could come in here and record right from this desk right here.
So after you go cook up in the studio, you know, you gotta come in here. This is where they lay down their tracks. They come in here, they get right in the booth. Then right in there, that's the psych wall that y'all just seen earlier. But talk about the people that have been in this booth and what this booth has done to your business. Immediate impact.
So we had some good traction just the same way with the videos. We had some really good traction with actually recording. So when we got in here, like I said, this was done about February, March, and we started immediately cooking up. So we had groups like my own artist, TRL, start to work in here, but then we started picking up. We had bigger name acts like Helluva started to use our studio a lot more as of recently. So we've been having a lot of more big name artists come in. Like just the other day, Payroll Giovanni was here. Lil Boosie
came to record here, like Kodak Black was here, like a lot of people have been coming in more recently and picking up a lot more traction. So yeah, we're going up right now.
Hey, you heard it here first, the Thenterview podcast.
Yeah, so, and through these hallways, what we're gonna do is have a contemporary art space. So right now, I've been working with a curator about getting local artists and people around America just to come and bring and sell their art here in the space. What we're gonna be doing is monthly artist market nights, and we'll have an online presence as well to be able to display and sell art for artists.
So you saying they gonna have they art here and mm-hmm. people come here and just buy it straight
yep,
off the wall?
Definitely, yep. We curating the art gallery here in the space. It's a one-stop shop for all mediums of art. So whether you're an artist, a poet, a stage writer, a rapper, a singer, whatever you are, whatever medium of art, you're gonna be able to do it here.
So would they the vinyls, would they put them up there?
Yeah, no, we're gonna get some plaques in here as well, yeah. Okay, definitely, yeah. Like when we record vinyls. These platinum selling records, we definitely gonna put these plaques up on the wall in here, yeah.
You gonna
yeah.
auction them up though?
No, we ain't auctioning them, we keeping them for keepsake. They priceless.
Hey,
yeah.
Hey, remember, own your masters.
Yeah, that's what we preaching in here, ownership. So yeah, what we doing in here is our photo shoot room. Like I said, I wanna build a one-stop shop for artists. And so they go in there, they create a song, and they got a vision for the creative direction. They can come right in here, have a photo shoot for their marketing, and then take it right back into the sidewalk room and shoot the video. It's the one-stop shop facility.
So now y'all about to see the next recording booth, right?
Yep. So what we're working on right now is the next phase and the second studio. This is what the studio looked like when we first got in here. We haven't even updated anything in this space at all. So what we're about to do in here is actually put a baby grand piano so that singers can get in key. So we want to make this like a really upscale vocal booth. Yeah.
So how long ago did y'all purchase the spot, and where did this whole idea come from?
So we purchased the spot. Well, we started touring this spot exactly a year ago in July. We had to do some negotiations with the realtor between Masonic and ourselves and our party. And we probably got in the space around close to October. We actually got the lease done in November, and we got to work in January.
January.
Yeah.
And so
the idea kind of developed from this.
Man, you feel me? Man, one of the owners, man, I got to go. I appreciate everybody, you know, tap in with us. We got some good stuff coming through, for sure. All right.
Yeah.
All
right.
Manage artists ourselves, and so what we needed was like a workspace, and we was looking for spots that was gonna allow us to do like a contemporary art look. And so we was looking for loft spaces, but we kept getting denied on the retail the commercial spaces because of noise violations. They knew we was looking for a studio space, and so they kept, you know, stamping us, saying no, we can't do noise violations after a certain time. And so we found out that they had unlisted space in the Masonic Temple, and we came to view it. And when we came to view the space, it was just a lot more than what we needed. But I saw an opportunity to do something bigger for the city and creative as a whole. Yeah. And so we just wanted to jump on it and say, all right, you know, even if we wasn't looking for something this large or a project this big, this is something that we know can be a lot bigger for everybody, all the budding artists coming out of Detroit, especially with that lens on us right now. We needed a one-stop shop, like the meccas, like L.A., Atlanta, New York, even Chicago got those big studios where you can go in there and get some professional work, quality work done, and have ownership in your own product. But we don't have that in Detroit, so that's what we're trying to push right now.
Facts, man. Detroit need that other wave, that second wave. That's what I call it all the time. We just need Detroit and then that other side of Detroit where everybody can come together, uplift, work on new stuff. You know, that Atlanta vibe, that Cali vibe, that New York vibe.
If we can get everybody to gel together and actually work together, then I think that we can actually break that mold, you know.
So this, what the booth look like from the other side.
So this is Studio B. This is what we working on this week. This is our next project. We got all the equipment for Studio B. We just waiting to do the cosmetic update. So we just got the fabric in. We about to wrap these three walls in this orange fabric. And then over here, we're going to do an accent wall with these tiles. And so this whole wall will be wrapped in geometric tile panels right here.
Hey, y'all didn't think it was this many rooms, did y'all? They only saw the psych wall online. They just saw the little booth.
They ain't know. Yep, and this is what we're working on after this. So within the next month, these two rooms will be done. What we're doing in here is actual producer's room. So we're going to have MPCs, beat machines, drum sets,
keyboards, everything like that, so a producer can come in and cook up, similar to this machine here. We're just going to have a bunch of these in here, so our producers just can come in here and make
it. So editors be in here too, or just really producers?
Really producers, but I'll actually show you, we got an editing room just specifically for editors on the way too.
Facts. Y'all see, we got this nice view of the whole city behind us, man. All the views at the spots with the vent, with the windows, all the different views. Lovely. That's what I like to call it. But this is real special, though. All seriousness, this is like real special what you're doing here. And I just want you to tell the youth or tell people who looking to do something how to take that next step versus just staying down or staying behind or not ready to put a real risk.
Yeah, sometimes it just take a minute just to even build up that confidence to step off the porch yourself. You know, it took me a little second, but what we want to do is just be able to preach ownership and product, especially with the advances in technology. It's a way shorter time from creation to market. And so we want to be able to help people of, like I said, all mediums of art have ownership in their art and actually say, hey, you know what? I can create this thing. Let me go out here and put it out, market it, and sell it myself. And so that's what we really wanted to do. And so, like, right here in this space is going to be our clerical office. So this is where, you know, we'll have our desk. But even in this room right here, we'll have editing stations for editors to be able to take what if they go do a photo shoot in there, they can come right in here, use Adobe, Final Cut, whatever, right, Lightroom, whatever software they need. Even we'll have directions for artists if they come make a song in here and they don't know the steps that it takes to put create an LLC, to get a business bank account, to getting distribution and distributing your song on your own, to putting in on SoundScan, Sound Exchange, all of the databases to where they'll collect your royalties and streams. We're going to do that right here because in this day and age, you don't necessarily need the label or the big machine behind you to blow. And so if you can do everything on your own, that's what we want to push and that's what we want to teach here at the spot.
So what age did you know you was going to be an entrepreneur?
I knew at 14 what I wanted to do. I had some obstacles I had to overcome. My parents didn't always see eye to eye with me on what it was that I should be doing. And so I did take the college route just so I could have a plan B. But my plan A always been trying to get here. And so completely losing focus on that plan B and just set my mind on plan A got me here. So since the age of 14, I knew what I wanted to do. Just took me a little bit of time to actually, you know, jump off the porch, like I said, and had the confidence to say, you know what, let me take a risk and build the route on my own. You know, I would applying for jobs with Warner, Sony, Universal, 300, you know, but when you don't have that resume built yourself, you got to go out there and build it. You know what I mean?
Right.
Yeah. So that's what I'm doing, building my resume.
Hey, make sure you build your resume.
For real.
We about to show y'all the site wall one more time because that's just that's the appealing part for me. You feel me?
Like a broad degree. It was lucrative. You need a management in hospital and health. You need management in sales. You need management in whatever. You know what I mean? So it was broad enough for me to understand how to start a business and how to run a business and learn all the pieces and the tools that it takes to have a business run, you know, efficiently. So that's why I went to the management route, because I knew I wanted to manage artists and actually have my own label. So that's what I did.
Dang. He literally said, turn your dreams
to reality.
For real. Like, he named his goals and went and did them. 6 months ago, this ain't look nothing like this. They had a plan. And I think that's what people need to be more big on, actually having a plan, mm-hmm. not just saying stuff. Because if you got the plan, stick to the plan, and then it happened.
Exactly.
You got to stick to the blueprint. Mm-hmm. But I just wanted to ask one more question. What's the best thing and the worst thing about having a spot, starting up, and how it is now? As far as people trying to use it or anything.
Yeah. Best thing about having a spot right now is actually being able to have a resource to provide to the city and to provide to the industry and in the media world and entertainment. So being that resource has actually opened up doors for me that I wouldn't have had I not been able to be a resource for others. You know what I mean? So that was the best part about having a spot right now. The worst thing I would say is I don't have a life anymore. Outside, you know what I mean? Outside of me working every day, all day, I'm up at 7 a.m., I'm here, and I probably leave here around 1 or 2 o'clock at night every night. And so this is my entire life right now until we really get this off the ground, until, you know, I knew it was going to take me about a year of sacrifice at least before I kind of get back to normal and swing things, even going out to the club, maybe even going to a bar. But right now, it just, you know, it'll be worth it in the end, me sacrificing that time right now.
So you haven't been out at all?
No, I ain't been out at all. I'm lying to you. I went out last night for the first time this whole year. I went to a bar last night.
Was it worth it?
Yeah, it was. Chill spot.
Chill little spot. Everybody got to reward themselves here and there. You say you worked hard for a year straight. No going out.
Yep.
No partying. Just stacking.
Straight grind.
Yeah, but y'all going to see what the spot look like 6 months from now. And it's going to be 10 times better. So
it'll be good.
I appreciate you for getting this interview in.
Thank
you know,
it's spotlight.
Yeah. You said he ain't used to it, but everybody got to get used to the spotlight here and there. Especially when spotlight can be on the spot. So, yeah, make sure y'all subscribe to the channel, tap in with the spot, and link all his stuff in the description.
Yeah, fuck with us.
Me too.
Yeah, her too.
Let's try it out. Let's get it.
Thumbs up.
Bitch to get back with her man, like I was cute. Boy, you can't mix that shit with your bare hands. Might try to use how the fuck I'ma cuff you, know you fuck my mans. You sound a stupid nigga, and in the fig, just be rapping about the crimes I'm doing. You know I can't.